Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Morning class.
Morning.
Morning, sir.
Okay, before we start the lesson today, let's recite al-basmalah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, well, students, today's topic it's still about adjective phrase. So, previous week or last week we have studied about this topic before. So today there will be a continuation of the previous lesson that we have learned. I'm not going to share the adjective the proposed learning objective, because I did it already before, so because of the time, so we're gonna make it a bit quicker. Right, so adjective clause and adjective phrase. How to reduce from adjective clause to be adjective phrase. Okay, so do you still remember what is the difference between adjective clause, between clause and phrase? Do you still remember?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is clause?
Clause is both of subject and adjective. Or adverb, sir. But the phrase is menjelaskan noun-nya, sir.
Ah, okay. So clause consists of subject and predicate. Yeah, group of words consists of subject and verb. But phrase, group of word without subject and without verb or predicate. Yeah, that is the difference. Yeah. So group phrase is group of word that may consist of noun and noun, consists of preposition and noun, or adverb. Yeah, that is phrase. It's a group of words. Jadi kelompok kata. Phrase itu tidak terdiri dari subjek dan predikat, tapi kalau klosa itu terdiri subjek and predikat or verb. Okay, so we studied about adjective clause already. Okay, so we can reduce adjective clause only when the relative pronoun is as a subject. And those relative pronouns are who, which, and that. So we talk about that already. So now we go further to the exercises. And comparison, we studied already last week, the comparison between adjective clause and adjective phrase, right? So here is the example. Mr. Ahmad, who teach biology in our class, is awarded as teacher of the year, right? This is adjective clause. This is adjective clause because why? This sentence, do you still remember which one is the adjective clause? Mr. Ahmad, who teach biology in our class, is awarded as teacher of the year. Which part is adjective clause?
Who teach biology?
Okay, who teach biology in our class? That is adjective clause. So, do you think this sentence or this group of words consists of subject and predicate?
Yes.
The subject is, what is the subject here?
Who, sir?
Yeah, okay. And then who referred to Mr. Ahmad, yeah. And then you find the predicate or the verb here?
Teaches,
yeah, that's correct, right. So now when we turn that into adjective phrase, Mr. Ahmad, who teach biology in our class, is awarded as teacher of the year. So there are two ways, there are two steps in changing adjective clause to adjective phrase. First, we have to omit or we have to drop the relative pronoun, what is the relative pronoun here? Who, yeah. And then the second is the verb or the predicate. When it's active, you gotta change the verb or the predicate to be present participle. Or verb one added ing. So then the adjective phrase of that adjective clause is Mr. Ahmad teaching biology in our class is awarded as teacher of the year. All right, understand? OK, Okay, so the next is, I'm going to pick this one, yeah? I'm going to pick this one. Badminton is a sport that or which requires skills, strength, and focus. All right, this is form B, yeah, the form B. Okay, and then how to change this adjective clause to be adjective phrase? First, you have to drop the relative pronoun. But what is the relative pronoun?
That or which.
That or which. Very good, right? And then, what is the next step when you drop the relative pronoun? And what is the next step?
Change the verb to be verb-ing, sir.
That's correct. Yeah, you change the verb become verb-ing or present participle. So it become badminton is a sport requiring skills, strength, and focus. Okay, right here. Here's the new one. It's not the new one, but to refresh your mind again. Yeah. So the girl who is sitting next to me is it adjective clause or adjective phrase?
Clause.
It's adjective clause. Okay. Can you change to be adjective phrase?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, and how?
We drop the who is, sir.
Okay, and then we drop the who and also the be, yeah. The be, that's good, yeah. The girl who is sitting next to me is May, and it become the girl sitting next to me is May, yeah. Oh, is here, yeah, is May. Okay, so what about if I change this one, the girl who sits next to me is mine. The girl who sits, I don't use is here. The girl who sits next to me is mine. So can you change that to be adjective phrase?
Yes, sir.
Yes, how?
We remove the who and change the verb to be verb-ing.
So okay, and become
sitting, sir.
Yeah, the girl sitting next to me is May. So is it the same? Yes, it's same. Yeah, when it is active, the verb is changing into ing, whether it is continuous tense or past tense or present tense, doesn't matter. Yeah, when it is active, and then you gotta change that to be verb ing or present participle. Okay, what about C? The girl whom I saw was May. So can you change that to be adjective phrase?
No, it's not.
Cannot. Why? Why, Khairul Mustafa?
Because clause can be reduced to personal adjective phrase is who, which, or that.
Okay, adjective. That's good. Right, because the relative pronoun that can be changed to be reduced, yeah, or to change to be adjective phrase only when the relative pronoun is a subject, as a subject, and those relative pronouns are who, that, or which. Okay, that's right. So here is the, okay, so if you ask me what is different between A and B, yeah, example A and B have the same meaning. They have the same meaning. Yeah, artinya sama. Yeah, only adjective clause that have a subject pronoun who, which, or that are reduced to modifying adjective phrase. Yeah, like you said before, yeah, whom cannot be changed to be adjective phrase. Yeah. Next. Okay, so what about this one? The man who is talking to John is from Korea. Can you change to be adjective phrase? Can you change that to be adjective phrase?
Yes, sir.
Anissa, okay. What about other students? Why Anissa and Khairil? What about other students? Where are they? Come on, I'm inviting all students. Okay, if you want a good score, so you have to be active and involved in our class, in our learning, okay?
Okay,
yes, so who will be changing? The man who is talking to John is from Korea. Can you change to be adjective phrase?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Putri Dini, yes, please.
The man talking to John is from Korea.
Okay, good, yeah. Okay, then the ideas which are presented in that book are good. Is it adjective phrase or adjective clause?
Adjective clause.
Adjective clause. Can you change that to be adjective phrase? Who can change that to be adjective phrase? Yes, who? How do you change this to be adjective phrase? First step is you drop the relative pronoun. And then the second, you drop the be form, the to be. And then do you have to change this verb into ing or not?
No, sir.
Why not?
Because kalau misalnya, ya gitu, sir. Kalau misalnya udah ada di situ to be-nya, sir, nggak usah lagi diubah verb-nya, sir.
Nah, okay, because it's passive, ya, passive sentence, ya. Kalimat pasif itu tidak dirubah menjadi ing, ya. Kalimat aktif dia berubah menjadi ing. Ini kan pasif, ya. Ide-ide yang dipresentasikan is that is passive. When it is passive, and then we have to keep that verb three, ya. The past participle keep to be there, ya. Harus tetap di situ, ya. Nggak dirubah menjadi ing. You just drop the relative pronoun and the to be. Here is the transformation from adjective clause to be adjective phrase. The ideas presented in that book are good. Okay, what about this one? Anne is the woman that is responsible for the error. Can you change that to be adjective clause or adjective phrase? Who will change that to be adjective phrase? No one?
Me, sir.
Okay, Anissa.
We remove the that is, sir.
Okay, that is, that and is removed. Okay, and then?
Then make it become Anne is the woman responsible for the error.
Okay, do you need to change the verb being there? Do you think the sentence has a verb or predicate or not?
No.
It has no predicate. Ya, dia nggak punya verb. Ya, kalau nggak punya verb, so the adjective, we keep the adjective there. Ya, jadi tetap aja adjective-nya di situ, ya. So this is the explanation. There are two ways in which an adjective clause is changed to an adjective phrase. Ya, ada dua cara. So if the adjective clause contain be form, ada to be-nya di situ, ya, to be form of a be, omit the subject pronoun. Yeah, the subject pronoun is omitted or drop it, and the be form as in example E and F and G, and also the be form is dropped or omitted or erased. Yeah, so that is the first, and then the second, the next is Paris, which is the capital of France, is an exciting city. Adjective clause or adjective phrase?
Closer.
Adjective. Clause. Okay, can we change to be adjective phrase?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please. Dini Putri.
We move which is, sir.
We move which is. That's very good. Yeah, that's right. So Paris, the capital of France, is an exciting city. But you keep the comma, ya. The punctuation is keep there. Jadi harus di tetap ada komanya. So here is the explanation. If the adjective clause requires comma. As in J, the adjective phrase also requires comma as in K. Yeah, J and K. Yeah, when this adjective clause has a comma, the adjective phrase also must have comma. You don't need to replace or you don't need to erase the comma. Okay. And an adjective phrase is which a noun follows another noun, as in it's called K is as a positive. This is called a positive. Yeah. Adjective phrase, here is the adjective phrase, the capital of France. So this is the adjective phrase, comma, and that is called a positive. Ya, ini sering biasanya itu di soal-soal TOEFL biasanya itu structure, ya. Paris is an exciting city. So the opposite, the capital of friend is the appositive. That what we call appositive. Ya, harus ada koma dan koma. Ya, it refer to Paris. Ya, it refer to Paris. You got understand? You understand?
Yes, sir.
Bisa dipahami? Paham ya?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So next is English as an alphabet that consists of 26 letters. All right, so here, if there is no be form of the verb in the adjective clause, yeah, if there is no be form, yeah, there is no be form of a verb, it is sometimes possible to omit the subject pronoun and change the verb to its ing form, as in H and I, H and I. So here is an example. English has an alphabet that consists of 26 letters, and then we change to be adjective phrase. English has an alphabet consisting of 26 letters. That was like we studied before, yeah. I, and then anyone who wants to come with us is welcome. Anyone who wants to come with us is welcome. The phrase become anyone wanting to come with us is welcome. So it has no be. Jadi nggak punya to be, yeah. That consists, yeah. Kalimatnya tidak punya to be di sini seperti yang sebelumnya. English has an alphabet that is consisting, not like that, but is this is draw, there is no is, and it's like a present. So where it's active, when it's active, and then the verb is changing into verb ing. Jadi tidak hanya kata kerja yang ing, yang present continuous ya, yang bisa dirubah menjadi ing. Tapi ketika dia tidak ada to be-nya, ya, when it has not to be and it is like present tense, so it can be changed into verb ing. English has an alphabet consisting of 26 letters. Or another example, anyone who wants to come with us is welcome. Who wants, not who is wanting, but doesn't matter. Even it is who wants, we drop the relative pronoun, and then we don't have to be here. And then so wants is the verb, wants is added ing. Anyone wanting to come with us is welcome. Can you understand? Bisa, bisa dipahami?
Yes, sir.
Okay, do you have any question? Do you have any question? Feel free to ask.
Minter.
Yes. Yes, please.
Untuk I'm sorry to using bahasa, sir.
Okay, no problem.
Kalau misalnya untuk essay atau writing test itu lebih baik menggunakan yang mana, sir?
Biasanya kalau essay to make it more simple and to vary your sentence, you use adjective phrase. It's more. Ya, artinya boleh-boleh saja divariasikan. Sometimes you can use adjective clause and sometimes you can use adjective phrase. Tapi biasanya dalam nulis-nulis berita atau essay, orang banyak menggunakan adjective phrase. Oke?
Okay? Di writing test atau gimana?
Di writing test both, ya, yeah, both oke, okay, ya. Yeah. Kalau dalam writing test, kalian bisa menganalisa. Biasanya maksudnya writing test bagaimana nih?
Yang seperti di IELTS, sir.
Bagaimana?
Seperti tes TOEFL or IELTS.
Ah, both ya. Biasanya keluar yang mana gitu? Dua-duanya bisa keluar ya. Both ya, both. So both are accepted ya. Semuanya benar ya. Yang paling sering digunakan ya, semua juga sering digunakan. So both are correct ya. Oke, okay, Anissa.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Okay, now how about this? If an adjective clause that consists of be plus a single adjective, if an adjective clause that contains be plus a single adjective is changed, the adjective is moved to its normal position in front of the noun it modifies. Nah, bagaimana kalau misalkan dia single adjective seperti ini? Fruit that is fresh tastes better than old, soft, mushy fruit. Fruit that is fresh. Ini kan adjektifnya tunggal, single ya. Ini kan adjektifnya single ini. Fruit that is fresh tastes better. Jadi ya tinggal ini kan adjektif. Nah, bagaimana kalau kita rubah seperti ini? Ya, ada relative pronoun, kemudian ada adjective. Ada relative pronoun, kemudian ada adjective. How to change that? Ah, kalian bisa kembalikan ke bentuk awalnya. Fresh fruit, ya, fresh fruit tastes better than old soft mushy fruit. Kalau kalian dibuat seperti fruit fresh, no, it's not correct. Ya, karena ada that di situ. Kalian hilangkan relative pronoun-nya dan is-nya. So it becomes fruit fresh. No, it's not okay. But kalian harus kembalikan kepada bentuk semulanya dalam DM, ya, dalam susunan bahasa Inggris. Fruit fresh tastes better than old soft mushy fruit. Bisa dipahami ini? Can you understand this one?
Yes, sir.
Ya, ini kata apa namanya? Adjective. Adjective-nya single. Fresh. Ya, ada adjective di situ. Ya. Maka dia menjadi di sini ada noun, kemudian di sini ada fresh. Ya, enggak bisa fresh fruit taste, but fruit enggak bisa menjadi fruit fresh, but fresh fruit tastes better than old soft mushy fruit. Okay? So now we're gonna practice now, yeah. So here are more example you can read by yourself. I'm gonna share this on our Schoology. You can have a look there, yeah. So how about maybe we can pick one? How about if it is passive? Yeah, we talk already passive. This is example. The books which were taken to library were English. So we drop the relative pronoun and also the to be. So it become the books taken to library were English. Yeah, that is passive. Jadi kita nggak boleh berubahnya menjadi ing. Yeah, she don't need to change that to be ing. Okay, so but we keep the past participle or the verb 3. Okay, now let's do exercise here. Change these sentences into adjective phrase or adjective clause. When it is adjective phrase, and then you gotta change to be adjective clause. When the question is an adjective clause, you gotta change to be adjective phrase. Do you understand? Grade 12, you understand? Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, number one. I read an article about Marie Curie, who is a famous French scientist. So, adjective phrase or adjective clause? If it is adjective phrase, then you have to change to be adjective clause. If it is adjective clause, and then you got to change to be adjective phrase. Who will answer number one?
Me, sir.
Anissa Pratiwi, yes, please.
Okay. First, we remove the who was.
Okay, so is it adjective phrase or adjective clause?
Clause. Number one. Adjective clause.
Adjective clause. Okay, change that to be adjective phrase then.
Okay, I read an article about Marie Curie, a famous.
Comma.
Yes, comma, a famous French scientist.
Okay, very good. Okay, number two. Who will answer number two? Number two.
Yes, sir.
Putri Dini, yes, please, Putri Dini.
Oh, I know him. He is my officer who turned down my proposal. Change.
Adjective clause or adjective phrase?
No, sir.
Adjective clause. Okay, change that to be adjective phrase then.
Oh, I know him. He is my officer who turning down my proposal.
Very good. Yes, that's correct. Number three. Who will answer number three?
Me, sir.
Khairil Mustafa, yes, please.
Mr. Hartman is a history teacher coaching badminton.
Clause or phrase? Is it adjective clause or adjective phrase?
Adjective clause. Sir.
Adjective clause. Can you change to be adjective phrase then?
Mr. Hartman is a history teacher coaching badminton.
Good coaching badminton. Okay, number four. Who will answer number four? Come on. Where are the rest? Where are other students? Come on. Number four. Yes, please. Siapa aja boleh?
Me, sir.
Okay. Yes, please.
This is adjective phrase.
It's adjective phrase. Okay.
The neighbor who killed my pet last night was a prisoner.
Ah, okay. The neighbor who killed past tense or present tense?
Past tense.
Past tense, ya. Yeah. Kalau dia past tense, maka harus yang past tense juga. Kenapa? How do you know that is a past tense? Last night, ya. Yeah?
Last night, sir.
Yeah, that's right. The neighbor who killed my pet last night was a prisoner. Very good. Number five, the last. Who will answer number five? Yes, don't wait too long. We're running out of time.
Me, sir.
Okay, Anissa.
I bought. This is a phrase, adjective phrase. So we change it to be adjective clause.
Okay.
I bought a novel who is published at Gramedia recently.
Is it right? Is it correct? Check again. Check again.
Careful. No, sir.
Who will fix it? Siapa yang oke, perbaiki boleh? Sama Anissa memperbaiki atau other student who want to fix it, please welcome. Okay, Anissa, oke, okay, Anissa, yes please.
I bought a novel which is published at Gramedia recently.
That's right. Yeah, I bought a novel which is published at Gramedia recently. Or you can say in present perfect tense, I bought a novel which has been published at Gramedia recently. Okay, so I hope all students understand not only Anissa Pratiwi, Putri Dini, Ekhairul Mustaqim, only three students, and I need more students to be involved and active, okay? Right, I think students, that is the end of our lesson today. And thank you very much for joining, and have a nice day, and we close by reciting Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. Waalaikumsalam.